All right, we have a Gendex 765 BC that is being set at 80 milliseconds. And when the exposure is pushed, you get a strange noise. Okay, just that little beep. And it goes down to 12. It does this every time. What we're going to attempt is to replace the capacitors on the board. We also have an over temp indication. Here we go. I think I fixed it. Here, I'll take one more shot. Okay, stronger beat. And boom, still 80. Go ahead and adjust it higher. Okay. Adjust it higher. Strong beat. Boom, did it move? Now here. Take this cover off. Alright, here's what I replaced. I replaced that. What is that? C60? Right there? C60 or is that C65? No, C60. Alright, C60. 66. C65 and C66, right there. You can tell they're the two without anything on them, okay? All the other capacitors, you can tell they've got some sort of writing on them, but those are the two I just replaced. That was the only thing I did. So, there it is. And we'll go back here, try it again. Nice strong beat. They said that this unit was malfunctioning for 2 months straight. They could not get a single x-ray out of it. Alright, and here's what I used. I used my desoldering iron, and these are the old capacitors, right, with their little writing on them. And this is actually a, what we got there, 100 microfarad, 35 volts. Watch this. Okay, so here are the two capacitors. These are the ones that I replaced. I'm going to go ahead, they're 100 microfarad, 35 volt. This is what I replaced them with. 100 microfarad, 50 volt. Same thing, same, same. Alright, so get this meter set up. Yeah, ferrets. There we go. Okay, there we go. Taking a measurement. Seventy-six microfarads. Should be 100. That's over 25% off. And these were the only two that I replaced. And we went from an unusable x-ray, 765 DC, to now I can't get it to fail at all. Alright, here, we'll try it sequentially. Three, four, five. Let's say we fixed it. Okay, all good.